Hello. I'm sorry, technical difficulties. It always starts like this. Many apologies. I don't know why my phone is not letting me rotate. Oh, it's so annoying. Oh my God, that's annoying. Holy cow. All right. I think I have to do this. Okay. Yeah. Can you hear me okay? Is the microphone working all right? Microphone's okay? I'll wait. Hey, bro. Just can you tell me, can you hear the microphone? Okay, cool. All right. Like when we are. Okay, all right. I think I got the technical difficulty solved. I think I do. Can you hear me okay? I know I have to wait like a half an hour for the response to that. Can you hear me okay? Okay, while I wait for a reply, I will have a sip of my drinky. Negro Modelo. Okay, because I didn't try anything fancy with electronics. I was trying to do a little setup with electronics, and then the equipment wasn't cooperating with me, and then I ran out of time. So thank you for letting me know that you can hear me okay. Oh man, you know, what a weird day. Things were going pretty good until about 45 minutes ago. I had a really nice lunch with my mom and my brother. Hi guys. And then I had been waiting on a quote from a contractor to redo my garage. I'll tell a little story, why the hell not, right? I own a home in Allentown in Buffalo, New York that was built in 1890. It is an awesome property. It is ridiculously huge. Square footage is stupid. I mean, good, it's great. And I'm fortunate enough to have a driveway and a garage. But the garage was in bad, bad shape. And for several years, my father, who's been great about helping me at the house, and I were fighting a war of attrition in which we kept trying to patch this leaky flat roof 1890 garage for like 10 years and getting nowhere. Just gaining ground one summer, losing ground the next summer. So anyway, we finally decided to dismantle this sucker and go for a rebuild and did all the estimates and everything. And my father and I tore it down all last summer, and it was unreal because the roofing materials were so heavy, unreal. And the old like calcified wood, they were like, the wood was like brick like. It was unreal. I saved some of it, and actually I was thinking of making a little stage out of a little section of it. Where I could thump on the stage with my my foot and tap out rhythms and stuff, and maybe even stick a microphone under it. So that's a to-be-determined project. But to get to the point, we took 13,000 pounds of material off this roof, and that still left two walls, which were eventually demolished by a contractor, for a total of 25,000 pounds. Incredible. I bet you garages weigh a quarter of that now, maybe a fifth or a third, whatever. Anyway, so we had been waiting for a quote. We got an initial quote for the rebuild, and now there were a couple of revisions to simplify the design, and the new quote that I got today, a half an hour ago, is $6,500 higher. $6,500 higher. Does anyone have $6,500 I can have? All right, enough. It's all sing. So that was my mindset and getting ready. Oh no. But I'll sing a song called Four Summers in One. And I wrote it last summer in response to how busy the summer was and tearing down the garage and this whole thing, because it felt like that was what was going on. It felt like four summers in one. It felt like, okay, yeah. Anyway, all right, enough talking. Four summers in one. I never had so much fun. Never was so wild at time at exactly the same time. All the time, all the time, all the time. all the time. Some say she's like 100 girls in one. They say she's like a young boy's first dream love. And when all day's work is done, we'll take the town when evening comes for some virgin one. Never had so much fun, never was so wild at time, and exactly the same time. Oh, soul section. That's the weirdest part. You finish the song and then dead air. You hear this, you hear the fan in the other room. So how am I doing? Is it okay? Sound all right? I've got a really low tech setup today. Okay, I see some hearts from Steve-O, so that's probably a good sign. Tonight I'm drinking Negra Modelo. Very yummy. Good summer beer. Okay. It's not as dark as it tasting as it looks. It's a little more kind. It's a Mexican beer, not unlike Corona. Okay, cool. The reason why I'm vertical instead of horizontal today is I tried. Oh, this is my next question. Is the audio and video synced up? Because I've done this 3 times now, and the 2 times that I used my iPad, which I have over here, the audio and video did not sync up. So people could hear me and see me okay, but it didn't match. Whereas when I use my iPhone, which I'm using right now, the audio and video did sync up. So can anyone let me know about that, please? Yes. Okay, great, thank you. So how are you? How's everybody doing? It's been a really pretty summer here, summer weekend here in Buffalo. I look forward to getting back out to my porch after I finish here. Okay, so let's see. What song should we do? How about Kathleen? Sorry for the things I've done, the way I've treated you and everyone else around. They don't wanna know me, now. But losing you is the one thing I could. I do. I started facing myself. Sometimes the truth hurts more than it helps. I had my chance to make things right, and I sat silent. Have a lot of ceiling in the shot, so let me try to bring the camera down without wrecking everything. How's that? Is that any better? I know it would be better if it was horizontal, but for some reason this time when I tried to do it through my phone, it would only let me do it vertical. They probably changed it or updated it, and now it does what it does. So that's really annoying. But I hope everybody's doing well in our crazy pandemic time. I think we're going to have to buck up for a tough year. I don't think that there's any way out anytime soon, unfortunately. Any of you who know me know that I'm not a big fan of the president, to say the least. I think he's a dangerous individual. I think he is a traitor to the Constitution. And there was a lovely article in the New York Times, either yesterday or today, about how he was apparently briefed, as were the National Security Council for the United States, briefed that the Russian government has been paying Afghan militants to assassinate United States soldiers for bounty. And the president to date has nothing to say about this, and today apparently disclaims any knowledge of this initiative by the Russians, which was discovered by American intelligence. So considering 20,000 lies and counting, I don't believe that for 2 seconds. So I would like to see Congress look into it further, whoever they have to talk to get some answers about the national security briefing, and then we can dispatch the traitor in the White House. That's how I feel. You don't have to agree, but that's how I feel. Anyway, let's drink to that. I mean, not to, you know, but I mean, let's have a drink just as solace. Okay, so otherwise, I hope you're doing great. I hope you're weathering well in a really tough time. We will get through it. Everything does pass. They will eventually have a treatment or a vaccine. I mean, I'm grateful that New York has been able to really get its cases down, because as I often mention, my friend Kim is a ER nurse. She works at ECMC, and it's, she said it has been better. It hasn't been as many cases. It has sort of leveled off, and we see that in the statistics, and thank God for that, right? So hang in there, everybody. So I'll try to sing a happier song to make up for my speech. All right, here we go. It's called Good.
Suddenly, you know.
it's a beautiful thing. Wake to what you can achieve when you believe in something. So that's called Good, and it's on All Star Heart, which is back from 2010. Holy cow, 10 years already. And I'm happy to say that my new CD, which is called Back with the Dreamers, is almost done. We have been working on the artwork and the mixing, and it's really coming along. What I don't know is if, because of the pandemic, whether the manufacturers are up and running. Even though CDs are a small part of the sales, they're super cheap to get now. And then it'll be available for digital and streaming stuff. Okay. Okay, here's a good one. This is on the next record. It's called Here. Grass ain't greener, life ain't sweeter than here. Free from fear, feel grace wash over your skin. Grass ain't greener, life ain't sweeter than you. Sky is clear, feel sun wash over your skin. If I could change my, if I could change my, if I could change my life at all, I'd keep each failure, I'd keep each failure. Yeah, baby, I'd keep them all. Grass ain't greener, life ain't sweeter than here. Free from fear, feel grace wash over your skin. I dropped my pick. I need it for the end of the song. Or do I? Brody! Mom, don't text me while I'm playing, please. No need to change, my, no need to change, my, no need to change my life at all. I keep each failure, I keep each failure, I keep each failure fall. Yeah, baby, I keep them all. Grass ain't greener, life ain't sweeter than you. Free from fear, feel grace, wash over your skin. Feel grace, wash over your skin. Okay, I may do without the pick. Oh, thank God. Okay. It's okay, Mom. It's just your screen, your text pop up while I'm singing. And then I'm like, oh, what's she saying? Oh, wait, I'm singing. Oh. Oh, my God. Okay. Well, I can see the sun going down. Against the trees, the way my house is facing east, so obviously you can see right now the light coming in from the east. It's nice because in the morning my patio, my outdoor porch patio on the second floor, gets sunlight, but it really kind of like the peak time in summer is kind of like 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. when if you really wanted to just get, I mean, if you were trying to get a tan, which I'm not, then that would be your time. And then once you get basically to 2 p.m., then it's, then the sun is kind of over the side of the house. It arcs around the side of the house, and then you got the heat without the direct sunlight. So that's kind of like my favorite time of the afternoon, 2 p.m. on. I do a lot of writing out there. I bring the guitar out sometimes. I've been working on a second book, so I like to work on it out there. It's my cat likes it too. My cat Gabe likes it, and my previous cat Gene liked it too. Gabe will sit on the corner of the porch and just hang out and stare down the street for a long time. I'll just leave the door open. He just goes up by himself. Nice. This is a great place to live. Except for the roofing expenses. It'll be alright. It's just money, right? Oh yeah, I didn't mention this part for anybody who came by. I'm having my 1890 garage, which has been demolished, rebuilt. And that's pretty pricey. And then also I need a new roof on my home as well this summer. So it's like I decided to bite the bullet and do it all in one summer. And yeah, those roofers, those guys get paid. So maybe I need to take that up at some point. But anyway, so that's what's on my plate. But that's a good segue. I will be donating any donations from tonight's performance to a charity of some kind. Usually I do an animal charity. So if you feel like PayPaling me for tonight's show, my PayPal address is contact@robfalgiano.com for PayPal donations. And probably they'll go to either 10 Lives Cat Shelter here in Buffalo, which they take care of tons of cats, like maybe like thousands a year, either them or the SPCA, one of the two. So thanks for tuning in. Really appreciate it. About what kind of song should we get? I'm looking over at the list. How about Supergirl? So this is on my current CD, Little Vision, and we got to finish up the video, but it's my fault that it's not done yet because Tom McDade, the director, gave me a first cut, and I haven't gotten back around to giving him my notes for the edits. And then once that's done, then there'll be a second cut and however many cuts until we arrive at a happy conclusion. Life flashed by upon a train, off the rails and headed for the train. Falling off the building, headed down. You swoop in before I hit the ground. Supergirl, please save me. Supergirl, crashing down around my feet. You lift me to the clouds so I can see. Supergirl, please save me. Supergirl, please save me. Supergirl, Anybody do anything super cool this weekend? I did a lot of cleaning, actually. I was pretty good. I needed to clean all of the different beds and little rugs and furniture coverings that my cat Gabe sleeps on. So I did that yesterday. And I hosed down the porch. And I repainted the porch stairs. Well, restained them, technically. And cleaned out the little cat shelters. I have a couple of cat shelters on my porch for the cats to hang out in the winter. My neighbor Rose is the one who really started that on this block. Rose has taken care of a lot of the stray cats in the neighborhood. She's a catatarian, you know, like a humanitarian, but a catatarian. That's all I got, folks. And she's great. She really takes care of the cats. She feeds the cats in the neighborhood. So I give her a case of the cat food every time I order for my cat. And she introduced me to the idea of doing shelters. You can make, if you're interested in helping stray cats in your neighborhood, you can make a shelter very simply using totes. You can also buy little heated ones. The one of the two that's on my porch is really nice. She gave it to me. It's got a little heating pad in it, and you just plug it in, and then during the winter when they come in, it's, you know, they're lying on the heating pad, and put a blanket on top of it. So that works pretty good. And then the other one, if you want to make a tote, you can make a tote. The best way to make a tote for a cat as a cat shelter is apparently to use two totes. Two totes. Puberty. You use a big tote and a little tote. And you put the little tote inside the big tote, and then you cut the hole for them to come in through both of the two totes. And then in between the smaller tote and the larger tote, you put some kind of insulation, which you can use straw is a good one, but not hay. That's what Rose says. I don't remember why, but use straw, not hay. So I need to go get some extra straw from the Home Depot for next year, because Rose says she's out. And so yeah, I was cleaning out the shelter yesterday. And then anyway, okay, so then you put the lid on the tote, and then my mother, my clever mom, a little entrance, like cone, around the two totes. It just slides right in. That way you don't have to, they don't have to risk being maybe cut by the cut marks from around the hole that you make between the two totes. Does that make sense? Okay, sorry. Okay, back to songs. So here's a new one for the next CD called Near and Far.
Like a star, still warm from the journey down. She floated in my life just like a dream. Can't know how long this scene goes on. Blessed and a gifted all. Fall like leaves, wish I could keep them in a jar. When you are with me, I feel more free. Yeah, that's the best feeling of all. Yes. distract me from afar. And I'm falling to your lap just like a star, still warm from the journey down. Oh, Christian, a gift it all. We are sparks in darkness. Yes, the light goes on, even near and near and near and near and far. Oh, near and near and near and near and far. Oh, near and near and near and near and far. Oh, near and near and near and near and far. Oh, we are near and near and near and near and far. Oh, near and near and near and near and far. Oh, we are near and near and near and near and far. Oh, near and near and near and near and far.
Squeaky! Woo! All right. Okay. Yummy yum. All right, so let's see, what time is it? Well, maybe we'll do a couple more and then call it. I appreciate your stopping by to hang out with me on a Sunday evening. Looks like it's going to be a pretty nice week. I'm planning, I hope, to bike tomorrow evening. I don't think it's supposed to rain. Let's see, taking a look at the list. Okay, so here's another new song for the next CD called Ocean of Emotion.
Sacrifice your pride, get to the banner stuff inside. Let the ocean of emotion rock and roll you. Let the ocean of emotion rock and roll you. So much time and love. Fear is just an obstacle to overcome. You should just let that shit go. Let it flow. Flow. Sacrifice your pride, get to the better stuff inside. Let the ocean of emotion rock and roll you. Let the ocean of emotion rock and roll. Oh, forever alone. You've spent enough time at home. Sacrifice your pride. Get to better stuff inside. Let the ocean of emotion rock and roll you. Let the ocean of emotion rock and roll you. Let the ocean of emotion rock and roll you. Let the ocean of emotion rock and roll you.
Ocean of emotion. Okay. I think one more and then call it an evening. Thanks for hanging out with me for Sunday songs, Sunday evening songs. I apologize in advance. I think I'm going to end on kind of a sad one. It's weird. So I've been working, I'm always working on songs. I've always got a couple of records going at once. And sometimes when I write a song, I don't really, if I work on it for a little too long, then I start to lose perspective on it and I can't tell really if it's good anymore. So sometimes I just put them away. And I had put this one away for like 2 or 3 years. And it's called Somewhere Outside the War. And when I dug it out, it surprised me. It just, I don't know, it wasn't what I had remembered it being. And I guess it's a bit sad, but it's a kind of about this couple on a beach, really it's like deserted island kind of story. So the lyric, I'd like to tell you the lyric, is somewhere outside the war, my love and I are free to be just as we choose. Kind of got to play the chorus through. To be just as we choose on an inlet by the sea. Somewhere outside the law, the lazy despair of hate, unspoiled by man, where all is grain and grapes. So that's the island. And then the chorus is, we are never coming back. So they're not coming back to the mainland. We are never coming back. And then after the chorus, the next verse is, I've learned to be handy, which is a little true. We made all that we have, except for this guitar I rescued from the sand. I'm gonna play for her all day. Right here beside the waves, we sleep beneath the stars. We've learned what birds in the water say, and we are never going back. So, somewhere outside the war. It's a very quiet song, that's why I'm coming in close. Despair of hate, unspoiled by man. We're all as grain and grapes, and we are never coming back. We are never coming back. We are never coming. I've learned to be handy. We made all that we have, except for this guitar I rescued from the sand. I'm gonna play for her all day, right here inside the waves. We sleep beneath the stars. We learn what birds and waters say, and we are never going back. We are never. That's all. Have a great week, everybody. Take care of yourselves. Be good to others. It comes back to you. Okay. Bye-bye.